Paul, I've often heard you say that your business is recession resistant. Has anything changed given the current economic landscape?
It certainly is a challenging overall economic environment, but we have been, as you say, resilient and resistant. We're not immune to recessionary conditions or near recessionary conditions, depending on who you talk to. But I think we have been consistent and able to, thankfully, maneuver and innovate and be successful despite maybe not an ideal environment.
Let's talk about that maneuvering. Of course, I would imagine a big component is food inflation and the costs of goods. How do you, I guess, how do you navigate that as consumers? When we go to the grocery store, we really feel that impact. What are your franchisees telling you? What are you seeing?
Well, thankfully, we are constantly in touch with our franchisees as well. We really look at ourselves as one big team with our broader folks out in all the restaurants across Canada. And we have our ear to the ground, especially thanks to them and also thanks to our marketing group and others that keep us up to speed. I would say that generally they've been very happy. I mean, our results have been very good consistently. We'll be reporting our next quarter. I believe it's August 10th coming up soon. But if you look back even at last quarter in the last few years, even through COVID, we really were able to weather that. And some examples of just how we maneuvered or adapted rapidly were, as many others did, but I think we were, more successful than some, I would argue, with things like delivery at home. Of course, delivery surged over COVID, which was actually great for our business, the delivery part of our business, but that's only about 60% of our business. The other 40% is really a walk-in business where you're walking down the street and you see a pizza, and you might walk in and get a slice or a salad or chicken wings with a drink or whatever. And that was mandated to zero because of COVID. No one could go anywhere, right? And so we had to really adapt. Even though our deliveries went up, our walk-in business went to zero. And so we had to really be quick about that. And we accelerated our app in-payment, prepayment, even pre-tipping for customers if they wanted to, much like a third-party delivery experience. So for those people that wanted to do that, we had to make it extra easy. And they probably didn't want to have any contact physically with a driver at that point due to safety concerns. So we would say, we enabled, just like other third-party apps do, through quick innovation in our app, within about 4 days, we had pre-tipping, prepayment within our app at the doorstep for people, with the pizza safely off the ground level and things like that. And so we just adapted quickly using technology, marketing, and then I think even beyond COVID, once all the doors were open and the channels were open and there was no more regulated constraints anymore, we also really made sure that we kept the line on pricing. We did have some price increases to our customers, but we tried to make them very measured and calculated. We didn't want to see our traffic suffer, and we knew that customers were really hurting. So especially in this inflationary environment, we said, let's make sure they're very judicious, make sure people still get the value for money and the hot and fresh pizza. So I think we sort of found the balance with innovation, marketing, and making sure that our franchisees were still operating well and that they felt customers were still very happy. And so it is a little bit of a tightrope always, with traffic and ticket, as we call it in the QSR sector. But I think we sort of found that balance overall.
How much are you affected by food prices, these escalating food prices and supply chain issues?
We're very much affected. I mean, anyone in the restaurant business, and other retailers, non-food retailers as well. And we're in the quick service retail sector, but full service retail also really suffered during COVID. And then after COVID, in this just inflationary environment that we're in, we saw double-digit input costs, inflation like we've never seen before, really coming out of COVID, just supply chain issues and constraints, whether it was cheese pricing, tomato sauce, dough, pepperoni, all the vegetable toppings. Also our non-food items, our suppliers, our beverage suppliers even had issues getting enough cans at one point and things like that. So there were supply constraints, which translated into essentially higher input costs for us and everyone else in the industry. And we had to really manage through that and make sure that we still had acceptable profit margin for our franchisees and still good value for our customers. And that's that real tough trade-off. But I think we were able to do that. And I think largely it's recovered. I think that these double-digit inflation increases that we saw have abated largely. We still have some pockets of concern, but it's not as bad as it was. And we've just, had to be extremely efficient at, being very smart about what costs we can control and managing our pricing accordingly.
You've talked about marketing and a few of the promos that you've rolled out over the last little while, the Buzz Off Pizza, most recently the Growflation Pizza. Do you think that these promos still resonate with consumers? You think they still work in this climate?
Yes, we know they do. I mean, we see it, the results in the numbers. And so the fixed price pizza that we brought in, even before the buzz off pizza, which was around Canada Day, having a bit of fun with, you know, this insect repellent with garlic and onions and things, natural insect repellents. That was a sort of a fun spike in demand, but very short lived for the holiday season. But the fixed price pizza offering we had for $16.99 for an extra large pizza with four toppings was great value. And we introduced that last year. We were going to have it for 1 year, but it was so successful. It became our second most successful special in our entire product mix and specials mix. So we've extended it to the end of this year. And so people really did identify with that. It was sort of a playful look at inflation, and people were getting hurt by interest rates going up and everything. But we said, here's a way to lock in your fixed price, at least for that one special, for a period of time. And it was great value and continues to be great value. So it, to be honest, it exceeded our expectations in terms of take up, validating how customers are feeling. And so that was one. And then the growflation is our most recent attempt to say, let's flip this thing on its head, this horrible shrinkflation thing where people serve things for smaller volumes, smaller packages for the same price. I think they can get away with it. And we said, that's not fair. Let's sell small. Let's upgrade the small to a medium, but we'll still charge you just the price of a small. So you're getting more pizza for less.
Our Financial Post team wants to know when you're bringing back the 30 minutes or it's free.
Well, we do have our 40 minute or free guarantee. It's been a long time since we had 30 minutes or free, but the guarantee, the time guarantee of 40 minutes is very, very, we think very powerful and very unique in the market. And we also want to make sure that drivers are safe as well. And you get the extreme weather in Canada, especially in the winter, where we don't want people speeding down the street. And so we found that 40 minutes still gives you a very hot and fresh pizza, but still it's there or it's free. And that guarantee is always there.
You've opened up your first international location just a few months ago in Guadalajara, Mexico. How's it going? What have you learned there?
It's been a really fantastic learning experience. We have great partners there that approached us. It's probably about 5 years ago now, I think it was. But we've been down to Guadalajara many times. They've been up to see us. They're actually coming to visit us this weekend, as a matter of fact. We're hosting a Mexican fiesta at our head office on Friday. And we're going to have some fun with them up here. We've actually got three restaurants now in Guadalajara already, and we expect probably another four or five by the end of this year down there. And we'll scale up from there and then into other parts of Mexico. But we're very happy with what we've seen so far down there. It's very much, for the most part, our same menu, but we do have some very unique items like an al pastor pizza, which is sort of a spicy pulled pork sort of pizza that people love down there. And some other items that are unique to Mexico. But we have things like keto crust pizza down there, just like we have up here. And we sell a lot of chicken down there, like we do up here. And so we're very encouraged by that. And we think it's a great template for other jurisdiction expansion as well. And so far, so good. It's early days, but we're very encouraged with our take up there. People are super excited to have us there. And our partners have proven to be, you know, fantastic people to deal with, which is a big part of it, the people.
Paul, you talk about expansion plans for Pizza Pizza, but given this high interest rate environment and given the fact that we're possibly staring at an economic slowdown, have any of those plans been, I guess, on hold, or have any of those plans changed? Has the strategy changed for you?
No, not really. I mean, I think we sort of you know, when we look at our strategy, it's very long term. We know how to pivot tactically when needed and adapt and change things. But we've actually been very consistent, you know, really even during COVID, post COVID, even in an inflationary environment with interest rates going up, to actually keep full steam ahead. We think it's a great opportunity to be on offense, but be very careful about costs. We can still expand and be very aggressive that way without letting our costs get out of control, and for new franchisees. So we think we have a very affordable, attractive model for new franchisees. It's very reasonable. We work with excellent top tier banks and even second tier lenders for some folks that maybe don't have the credit to get the top tier lender, but we've got an excellent record with our banks, our financial institutions that work with our franchisees who put some money down and they can finance the rest. So we think we've also found ways to keep our construction costs in line, because those have gone up as well. Cost of ovens, cost of construction, cost of labor. Those are all headwinds for sure. But we found we've been more and more and more efficient, and you're able to still manage that. And if anything, really go on offense when others are being very careful and retreating. But we're still being very, very careful financially, because we do not in any way, you know, overstretch ourselves, and we don't want our franchisees to get in that position either. So you have to be sort of financially optimized, but that doesn't mean you have to slow down. So we think even this environment, we can go full steam ahead, and we are.